Again, everybody out there who loves the little critters, this is Emmett Brady back with another late night edition of the Insect News Network. And I'm sitting here on a rather balmy evening in February in California, looking at all the plants that are coming out for the spring. And rest assured, even if you're in a part of the country that's getting blanketed by a snowstorm right now, underground stirrings are afoot. Eggs are being laid and chambers are being burrowed, and a new generation of custodians are about to spring forth from the insect world. Of course, I'm talking about the ants. And if you haven't seen the latest headline news this week from the world of myrmecology, which is the study of ants, they have mapped a large chunk of the ant genome. Now, many of the articles seem to refer to the same species of ant, the Argentine ant, which is, of course, a global phenomenon. It's a super colony, super organism that is also, unfortunately, considered by many people a pest. So whether you're a gardener, a farmer, a scientist, or just someone living at home, you've probably had the Argentine ants invade your house. And so many of the scientists quoted about how the discovery of the genome might lead to new types of pest control, either through the egg laying process or the reproductive process. But one scientist in particular pointed something out. He's at the Cal Academy of Sciences. He's a world-renowned myrmecologist. His name is Dr. Brian Fisher. And he was quoted as saying that this genome discovery might provide humans with some important tools. He actually said, knowing their genome means that eventually the genes enabling the Argentine ants to resist diseases may lead to ways for improving human resistance to all kinds of human diseases. Now, from my perspective, that is about the ripest bit of cultural entomology to hit mainstream media in a long time. I went to Fisher's website, and he has a video, too, where he proudly pronounces that ants did it all before humans. They were farmers, they had animal husbandry, they built cities underground, and at the end of this little video clip, he actually says that without the insects, they are actually what keeps the human society together. So, the question can be asked, what can we learn from insects? And in my mind, I said, well, what did we learn from insects? And I was reminded of some Hopi mythology. Hopi Indians are from the southwest United States. And back in 1963, an American historian, author, and anthropologist named Frank Waters documented many of their legends in a book called The Book of the Hopi. And in it, he talks about the fourth world myth. As the story goes, humans inherited the earth three times and they had paradise on earth, but they did something to screw it up. Imagine that. Either through their arrogance, their infighting, their desecration of the environment, or their lack of reverence for a higher power. They had nirvana and it was taken away and it was destroyed by the sun god Tawa, and more specifically by his creator god, who was Sotoknang. And Sotoknang destroyed the first world in fire, the second world in ice, and the third world by flood. Well, certain humans in each one of these societies were chosen to be taken underground and taught the ways of the earth by the ant people. Now, however one interprets that story, I find it very, very compelling that these humans were taken underground, they were taught the ways of specifically how to harvest beans, and now the Hopi do an annual celebration to honor the bean ritual. And then after the disasters, they took them back under up ground, and the humans started all over again. Interestingly enough, the Hopi Indians have entrance underground they call Kiva, and in Sanskrit, the word Kiva means first people. So, whatever correlations can be drawn, this is part of the fun part about the new world we live in. These fantastic scientific discoveries, these fantastic stories from the ancient world are finding some sort of synthesis, and that's what cultural entomology is all about. So, until next time, we'll see you on the Insect News Network. The ants are coming, and you and I probably have a lot we can learn from them. Imagine that.